Now, if I should ask what is the most important gadget, a lot of people call it transformer. Why? Because it's transformer that has the power that flows. A lot of people say probably it's the amp. Some of you say it's the drum. Some of you will call various things. But you discover that there's something that is very little that we despise. And that is the changeover. Now, no matter the power that the transformer has, if the changeover is in the wrong segment, it will not work. I don't know if you observe that. All the power that the transformer is transmitting will not get into the home. That means the gadget inside the home are dependent not on the transformer alone, but on the changeover. Now, that the problem is that everything we need to be successful, everything we need to be great, everything we need to amount to greatness in life, God has given it to us. We are the changeover of our life. Now, whether we fail or we don't fail, is determined on us, not God. Why? Because the changeover is a medium. And the medium of anything is the most important thing you should note. For example, if I call somebody to interpret what I say, for example, let's say I don't speak English, I speak French. And I tell the person in French, bonjour, that is good morning. And the person tells you, you are homework, for example. Now, what I ask the person to say is good morning, but what the person said is reverse of what I said. Now, you guys will leave angry. Why? Because what the medium said to you was wrong. So, the problem is not God, the problem is ourselves. Because we are the medium of our life. We are the medium of our life. God has said, okay, God said, I created everything perfect. I created everything in my image. I created you wonderfully and fearfully. Now, if you are an artist, you understand what the term fearfully means. Now, fearful in the Greek terminology is that expression that an artist has that is afraid to make mistakes. I don't know if you have ever tried to break a cake before or to a very delicate job. I know that the person that has this job has taste. I know that any mistake can spoil the job. That fear of not making a mistake, God has before he wanted to create you. And now that fear, God has created you. Now, I've not seen it in history that God created something that failed. So God created you to succeed. And now you fail, and you have God to blame God. Now, even if our faith is not determined on our success, whether we become successful or not is our own. That's why God himself, he placed the responsibility for success in our hands. Tell your neighbor, I'll be successful.
I'll be successful.
Tell your neighbor, I'll be successful.
I'll be successful.
Now, why are we changing about our life? The reason why we are changing about our life is one word, will. Everybody say the will. Now, the will is the most greatest and most dangerous gift God ever gave to humanity. I will explain that. The human will is the most greatest and the most dangerous will God ever gave to humanity. Why? Because the will enables you to choose against the one who gave you the will. That means God gave you a will. The only thing that he has that he gave you, and that will that he gave you can make you choose against the one who gave you the will. That means if God tells you to go right, you can tell him I want to go left, because he has given you a will. Now, because we have that will inside of us, that means if God says we should do something, if God has placed a parameter for success, when he says the book of the Lord shall not depart out of your mouth, and it means you should meditate day and night. If you don't meditate day and night, it is, and you don't become successful. Now, what happens when we blame God? We always blame us. We always want to find fault. We always want to look for people. We say it's our mothers that came here to us, our parents were poor, our village people were too strong, everything. We always want to look for a reason why we are not successful. But the only reason we have, if we should fail, is ourselves. Because God has enabled us. I've never seen a bird that cannot fly. If God created it to fly, it will fly. If God created an animal to run, it will run. If God created an animal to go, it will run. If God created a plant to go, it will go. God created us to dominate. He says, let man have dominion. So if your failure to dominate is not God's problem, but yours. And I want to say this. As a leadership coach, I understood that when it comes to leadership, we believe so much that leaders are some group of people that probably they are chosen by the gods, or they are some elite group of people. But yet, to tell judgment, Bible says, let them have dominion. He was not talking to the airlines, he was not talking to their widow parts, he was talking to you and I, he was talking to everybody, he was talking to the 7.2 billion people. He said, everybody can rule, everybody can govern, everybody can rule in their areas of gifts, everybody can be great, everybody can be successful. It doesn't start with your power of choice, your will. Making it, telling yourself that I want to be this and I will be this. Because whether I like it or not, God is a God that he has seen from the end before he starts. That's why in the beginning he says, in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth. And Jesus says the earth was without form and void. That means God finishes, he creates before he creates. That means he finishes something before he starts. That means he has finished us. He knew our end. He told Jeremiah, he says, I know you, I formed you, I made you. same God that we serve, He knows who we are. He knows the better version of who we are right now. So failure to become that person is not God's problem, because He is always willing to what? To let it out to us. So what am I trying to say is that everybody can be great, everybody can be successful. Just like what the wise man said, he says, even a dummy can be successful if he only wants to. If he wants to pay the price, he's willing to pay the price. With this, I rest my case. Thank you.